This is the heavy-duty Alaska gear with the heavy-duty cables. I did not wash this airplane. We don't have any water here at this airport, and the airport's been closed for a couple of months. So I didn't get to wash it before I took this tape. These are the Bodell wheels. And the 26-inch Tundra tires. The section of fabric that needs to be replaced is right there, and I don't know, I wasn't going to replace it anytime soon. I imagine it's got several more years in it, but it's starting to look kind of ragged. It catches all the exhaust and oil and everything. These are the wear marks showing how much is left of these Tundra tires. When you get down to the bottom of that hole, it's time to change tires, evidently. They've put a new kind of door latch on it. In the center is where the old one was, and that's the new one. These are new heavier ones here, and these are the new sealed struts. Here is the battery compartment door. They call it the baggage door. And above that, this is the metal hatch that lifts up. Wes, you want to go lift that hatch up for me? There's where the strobe sits. There's the antenna. Other way, I think.
Come on.
His arms aren't long enough. The cap there is what they used to fill the hopper with when it had a hopper in it. This is metal. And it's hinged along the top there. Pretty handy for loading stuff in the baggage compartment. Okay, this is a solid piece of metal. Go ahead and run your finger down it there and all the way down. All the way across. All of that's a piece of metal, so I guess it qualifies as a metal headliner. This is the empennage. We put black electrical tape along the leading edges to keep rocks from nicking them. Thing's got some grease on it. Now the bottom of the rudder here has got, there's an old patch there evidently. And then there's a little paint cracks running up from the bottom there. We put the piece of tape there that's been there for several years because that's a bad place where rocks nick it too. The tail wheel
tire is new. I think I put that on last year. And see some places where the white paint has chipped off on the tubes there.
This is the underside of the left horizontal stabilizer. You can see there's some paint chipping going on there. We've got real thin paint crack running along where his finger's going. Go ahead and move it across there. Starting there and go ahead and move it across. And then there's a little there, and then come on across. I'm having him show it with his finger because I don't know how these pictures are going to turn out against this white paint. Okay. Now, also up along the top, well, no, up on there, that one, yeah. There's a crack running down there. Those have been there for several years and they don't seem to have gotten any worse. That is a patch that was put in, I don't know how many years ago, I'd have to look in the book to see. There are some blemishes right there. And a few more stars right there. I'm gonna switch over to manual focus and see if I can do this a little better. There, you can see them there. Those are just little stars of paint crack, and those have been there for a while. The tops of the wings seem to be in good shape. I don't see much cracking on them at all. In fact, I can't find any. There's one small where the tape is, paint over the tape is cracked there. And there is a old patch right there on the underside of the left wing. These are the booster tips. There is a, we redid this section here, refiberglassed this corner right here last year, and you can see that there is a crack in the paint there. This is right above the left-hand landing gear. In the years past, evidently there was a fuel leak in the selector valve there, which took the paint off of that. I have never bothered to fix that. It doesn't seem to harm anything. The three dark spots that you see there are cracks in the paint. I'm hoping that this thing is focusing. It's pretty tough to do against this enamel paint. And there are two spots there where the paint has chipped off. Here was a crack. Evidently it's fairly common, a crack in the boot cowl, which they fixed by drilling holes in the end of it, and it seems to have stopped it. That hasn't changed since I've owned the airplane. The pitot tube has a little paint missing right there. We've replaced all of the oil cooler lines, or all of the oil lines, with flex hoses, just for peace of mind. All of the air ducting hoses have been replaced. There you can see some of the flex hoses on the oil line. There's a standard oil cooler, standard filter. We have a cover that goes over that hole for the oil cooler for the winter time, which we need. This is a crack on the other side of the cowling. Same thing happened, and they stopped it by drilling holes. Pretty clean engine. It doesn't use almost any oil. We have a new mag last year. Here's a shot of the panel. Once again, I don't know how these pictures are going to come out. Standard wooden floor. The mag's switch evidently used to go right there. It is now on the dash in the form of a key switch. These are the Cub Crafter seats, which I can't say enough about. They make long distances in this thing much more comfortable. The plexiglass has not been washed and is awful dusty, so I don't know how this is going to come out. Here's the Sigtronics intercom. Shoulder harness for the front seat. You can actually see some of the old red and white paint right there. There's some cracking in the paint right there, here, and on down. Go ahead and shut that hatch for me, would you, Wes? This is the worst part of the paint cracking on the underside of the right-hand wing. When I bought this airplane, the stitching was loose from a couple of the ribs, inboard ribs, so we repaired that. And there's just some blemishes there that you can see. We put a piece of tape over one small crack, and you can see a blemish right there, right above and to the left of that inspection cover, that's an old patch. That's not actually a problem. That's just an old patch, and they didn't quite match the paint. And there's another one right there. This is where the strut attaches to the right-hand wing. You can just see the cracks in the paint there. This is the Sensenich prop that came with the airplane. This is the Bora prop that's on the plane.
The metal belly. See if I can get any indication for you the shape it's in. Certainly not clean.
We have a paint crack, and I don't remember whether we did this one or not, but this is on the right-hand side towards the tail. Go ahead and run your finger along it there. This is above that. And this crack runs. Go ahead and take your finger and go on with it, Wes. There. And we've already covered this, but I just wanted to show these blemishes again. And there are some cracks around here, and then here, little stars. On the right-hand booster tip, there's a little chip right there. This section here was redone last year, 2 years ago. There's a blemish on the interior, left-hand side of the rear seat. The trim.
This is the Joseph State Airport. We're at 4,130 feet.
This airplane is kept in the hangar all the time. This is dry country. We get an average of about 15 to 17 inches of precipitation a year.
look like they're in pretty good shape.
Yeah, I don't think they've been ridden much.
Hell, if I knew you were going to bring him down, or you, I'd let you, one of you guys drive him a pickup.